Yes, Lord. Thank you.
And
yes, Lord.
I can only imagine how unworthy Hannah felt. I can only imagine how she felt like she had no purpose in life.
Uh-huh.
And oftentimes when we go through life and it seems like we can't see God, there is a purpose inside of us, whether there or not.
Yeah.
Hannah did not have a child at the moment, but yet she has purpose.
Oh.
Glory God. It's just like people that we deal with, just like Penaya, how she would talk about Hannah and how she would say things to Hannah to hurt her and discourage her. But Hannah, she still had the strength to love God.
Yes.
Despite of what folks said about her, how they looked upon her, she still had the strength to love God.
Yes.
And even as Hannah began to go before God in prayer, and like I said in the passage, Eli watched her as she prayed, and he assumed that she was drunk because her lips was moving, but nothing from her voice was coming out. How many of you know that sometimes it hurts so bad that we can't say a word? But God, He sees our heart. He knows the meditation of our heart. So thanks be unto God that I don't have to always open up my mouth, but He sees my heart. He sees where I'm going. He sees and He knows what I need. And here I love about Hannah, because she went before God and she, I can imagine, she just said, God, here I am. God, I've been through so much hurt and so much pain.
Yes,
I don't know what to do. Everybody's talking about me.
Yes.
Everybody's laughing at me because I'm not like everybody.
Yes.
I'm not able to bear like everybody.
Yes, Lord.
But God, I had to suffer to get to where you're going to want me to go.
Yes.
And then here Hannah is, and she begins to pour her soul unto God, and she begins to release it all unto God.
Uh-huh.
And that's my assignment tonight. I come to teach you the significance of pouring. Throughout the Bible, pouring was so significant, even in the Old Testament, when they was anointing a king, and when Saul was anointed, when Saul anointed David, and he went and got David, and he found David, and he put all in the ram's horn, and he poured it on David, and it signified when he poured it on David, there was a transition in the pouring. He was not king yet, but there was because of the pouring of the oil.
Yeah.
And one of my favorite passages in Matthew chapter 26, I am a worshiper, if you don't know, and this woman, she